Hello, and welcome to ShipU Stats. In this video, we're going to go over how to do a Pearson's correlation. A Pearson's correlation is a statistical test used when you have two normally distributed scale variables, and you want to know if those variables vary with each other. In this video, we're going to go over a Pearson's correlation example. We're going to show you a research question, we'll show you how to put your data into JASP, we'll show you how to run your data in JASP, and then we'll show you how to write up your results in APA format. Onto our research question. For this example, we're going to use this research question here. I'm interested in knowing if the number of friends someone has, and the number of hours they spend working per week, and the number of hours they spend on social media are related to each other. To do this, I collected a sample of individuals, in this case college students, and I collected data on these three variables. I determined the number of friends they had, the number of hours they spent working per week, and the amount of time they spent on social media per week. Now that we have our research question, it's time to enter our data into a spreadsheet. Here I have all of my variables and the data listed in each column. I've also added another variable called participant number, and this will help us keep our data organized. I've entered our data such that each row represents a participant. So for example, participant number one, all of participant number one's data is in that row, and it's not in any other row. Now that we have our data entered, we can go ahead and save it as one of the appropriate file types, and then open it in JASP. Now that we have our data in JASP, we can go ahead and run our correlations. However, before we run our correlations, it's important to think ahead. We are going to need different descriptive statistics for our different variables when we write these up in APA format. Specifically, we're going to need our means and standard deviations. To get these, we can just go ahead and click on descriptives, and we can go ahead and move over the variables that we want descriptive statistics for. By default, JASP should have selected mean and standard deviations already, and you can see that those are reported in this table over here. If they're not there, you can go ahead and click on statistics, and then go ahead and select mean and standard deviation. Now that we have these descriptive statistics, we can go ahead and run our correlation. To do that, we're going to go ahead and click on regression, and then on correlation. Again, we're going to move over the variables that we want to correlate with each other. And once we've done that, you'll see that our answers are already over here. That's because Pearson R is selected by default. If it was not selected, go ahead and make sure you select it. Now that we have these results, you can see that we have our Pearson's correlation and the corresponding p-value for the correlations between these different variables. A correlation table functions as a grid, so you can easily identify that this correlation is between the number of friends and hours worked per week. As you can see, I have a strong negative correlation between hours worked per week and number of friends. I have a weaker but significant correlation between number of friends and hours spent on social media. And I have an insignificant but negative correlation between hours worked per week and hours on social media. Now that I have my results, I can go ahead and write these up in APA format. Let's take a look at some APA format examples. Here we have an APA format example for each of the three correlations we previously ran. Before we get into the details of each of these examples, let's just talk more generally about APA format. As a reminder, when it comes to APA format, exactly how we write these sentences is kind of up to us, as long as we convey the appropriate information. When it comes to a Pearson correlation coefficient, there are a few things that are important to convey to the reader. The first is, what statistical test are we running? In this case, we're running a Pearson's correlation. So we've conveyed that to them here in our first sentence. We then want to convey whether or not we had a significant correlation or an insignificant correlation. And we also want to convey the direction of that correlation. In this case, we have a negative correlation. We then want to convey the information about that particular correlation and its magnitude. Here, we have R to symbol a Pearson's R correlation. We're then going to put our degrees of freedom in parentheses right after that R. And to calculate our degrees of freedom, all we need to do is to take our sample size and subtract 2 from it, or n minus 2. We then list our Pearson's correlation coefficient itself. In this case, it was negative 0.55. And we're going to round this to the second decimal. We'll then report our p-value at the end. The next thing that's going to be important to report is the variables that are involved in this particular correlation. We're going to report the means and standard deviations of those two variables, as well as exactly what those variables are. And as you'll see in these examples, I've repeated that same thing for each of these different correlations. In our second example, we have a significant positive correlation between two variables, and I've reported all of the relevant information. And in the last example, we have an insignificant correlation, and so we're going to denote that it's not significant, and we're going to report that it has no direction. All right, now that you have these examples, you should be able to complete a Pearson's correlation and write it up in APA format. Thanks for watching this video.